Aries, what will October bring forth for you? It is a big month. It is a life-altering month for you. And I'm so happy to say that you transcend this month with so much grace, dignity, strength, and abundance that it leaves me a bit speechless. But hey, you're Aries. So let's take a look and see what's happening for you. You have this energy of smoke and mirrors. And it is followed by the energy, the word Lord. Somebody who communicates very well, but they will praise you, and that at the same time, they will be dishonest with you. So smoke and mirrors and the word Lord are very similar energies. And when I look at the spread of cards, we will delve into where I think that person is impacting you in your life, okay? Now, the advice of spirit is getting back to integrity, the lost compass. So sometimes people, to get along with people, we almost have to go along to get along. And I feel very much that you feel very twisted around. You feel as though you've lost your path. You feel as though someone has created a burden for you, as we see in the very first house, that you need to really bounce back from. Getting back to your integrity, getting back to who you are, and not being caught up in somebody else's burdens that they bring into your relationship is how you're going to do it this month. The forest, or the Lord of the forest, is all about being grounded, being stable, being yourself. Very much the energy of what you need to deal with smoke and mirrors and somebody who is less than honest with you at all moments. So Aries, you have this beautiful energy of manifestation that is just powering through your reading. When we look at the very first card, the card that represents you coming into this reading is that you have been carrying somebody else's burdens. You have now decided that you are not going to deal with smoke and mirrors. You're going to find your way into your old self, or a self that was you prior to the time this person entered your life. This could be anybody. It can be a boss. It can be a lover. But this person is very significant and has a very big impact on your well-being. Good news. You are packing your bags emotionally, and you are not allowing anyone to deter you from taking what's yours, from taking yourself with you, and you are marching straight into the chariot. Look at this energy flow of where you're going this month. So you're giving up the burdens of other people. You're not going to engage with them. You are turning your back on this burdensome situation. So it is leaving, and it could be leaving anything that qualifies as a burden for you, be it job, person, situation, housing, whatever. We see you going, riding like the emperor you are, Aries. You are driving your chariot in for a victory. You are looking to make a lot more money and to earn a lot more, and you are not very interested in anyone who wants to underpay you. We see you in this very intense energy and being very desirous of a stable, happy home life in which you have a home that you really love. You're not there yet. We see that as a stairway to heaven. It is something that you will ascend to. But we have the Page of Pentacles. If that takes making and learning new things, if it takes going back to school, whatever it takes in terms of learning, because pages learn, you are willing to do that. The energy of your, you know, day-to-day health is being impacted by someone who is not really honest with you. When you look at your unhappiness level, when you look at your psychological well-being, you're feeling very sad right now. Day-to-day, I think you wake up and you struggle as to why somebody close to you, certainly the smoke and mirrors person who is not being fully honest, is impacting you, and you're starting to feel very sad. You're starting to kick over the cups of love, and you're really headed in this direction. So we see you sort of like being willing to let something go. The Page of Swords says that you are watching this person very carefully. And when we look at what they are doing in your life, what I see is that when their influence is that they see you as a beautiful Queen of Pentacles. They see you as very powerful. They see you as a person who is very reliable. That is something they like. Financially, as a partner, in a grounded manner, they tend to be grounded. Now, I usually like the Magician card, but I feel as though in this instance, given the fact that we have the Hermit, given the fact that we have the Devil and the Three of Swords, the Nine of Swords, and the Moon card, I feel as though smoke and mirrors is very much the Magician's energy. And it doesn't seem, you know, when somebody praises you, it always seems very magical and very beautiful. You know, when we look at this energy in regard to the Magician, you know, that's where we see the person is deceptive with you. It's almost like they will, if they find it worthy of their time or energy, they will stroke your ego to keep you in the relationship. When it comes to financially, you know, especially if you live with this person, I get the Hermit card and the Moon card indicating that financially they are not feeling very generous. They are breadcrumbing their contribution. So if you are dealing with somebody in your life that is a partner type person, whether it be business, whether it be, you know, any type of partner, which can include also like, you know, doctors, lawyers, financial advisors, realtors, agents, you're not getting the truth here. You're not, they're hiding something because we have the Moon card. They're sort of playing around with the idea of what they're going to do. The ghosting, you know, you're feeling very ghosted right now. This person is deliberately making you feel a little uncomfortable because they want you to rely on them. They want you to need them. And they have built that aspect perhaps into the relationship. And sometimes we do this as parents with our children, as, you know, we all invest differently. But what I'm seeing right now for your Aries is that you are leaving any energy behind that's burdensome to you, which is the manifestation that I see for you. When we get the energy of the Wheel of Fortune turning in your favor, we see that you get an offer, you get something through the mail, you have a chance to communicate locally and to do something very locally in your neighborhood with the Wheel of Fortune. That shows me that, you know, you could move, you could go somewhere else, and this person sort of doesn't want to hear it. This person doesn't want to hear about your dreams. They don't want to really hear about what you're going to do. They're not highly invested. Nine of Swords is saying this person has their hands over their ears. These are very non-supportive cards. The Hermit with the Moon. I like the Hermit normally, but with the Moon, it's non-supportive. Here you have, as you get good luck, as things turn around for you because you are standing on top of the wheel, this person isn't so happy to see your good luck. When we get the energy that of what they're bringing into the home life, it's like this energy of when you're having a party, when you're drinking, when you're having fun, you know, happy-go-lucky, easy breezy, it's okay. But when you get into the more, the bigger issues of how are we going to do A, B, C, or D? Are we going to buy a house? Are we going to move? Or what are we going to do? It does show that there is some competition. There's competition almost for, you know, your stability in your own home life. And it's just, it's egocentric arguing. It's petty. It's not very important. It doesn't usually really hurt you. But nonetheless, it takes the fun out of things. But the cards that I see that I really don't like is that your 12th house is your subconscious mind. It's your mental health. It's your well-being at its deepest core. And right now we have Pisces there. And what we hear from Pisces is that you're very intuitive. You're very intuitive, Aries. You always have been. And what I see is that you have devil energy. This person is very manipulative. This person is in some way really hurting you. Three swords through the heart is not minor. And you're very innocent. You know, you get her white cap. She didn't do anything to deserve this, you know, when we look at this energy. She just didn't. And so with that devil energy, you know, it's a beautiful, you know, the devil's quite handsome, but we can see the strings that are being pulled. And your reaction to that is very appropriate. You're like, what is going on? You know, I feel sad. I feel abandoned. And with these, the Moon, the Nine of Swords, the Magician, and the smoke and mirrors, Aries, you know, you do have to be very mindful this month. Now, for those of you, this could be, again, a business partner, somebody at work, a boss. Take it as it resonates. But Aries, you are in a beautiful time of manifesting your hopes and dreams. It is very powerful. You know, the one thing that I will say to you also is that this person and their impact on you are making you fly ahead on the back of, you know, on the top of this chariot. This person has motivated you so thoroughly that you are going to be nonstop heading into a much better life, a victory, a lot more earnings, a lot more feeling of being in control. You are a powerhouse. I commend you for seeing the truth of the matter, and I commend you for the power and the grace and the dignity you have of finding your lost compass. In the recent past, you and a lover or beloved were willing to release one another. You were on the verge of a breakup, or you may have broken up and released this person. That is the energy of the recent past for both of you. The current energy right now is the Two of Cups. You're in union. You stayed in union. And we're really seeing that both of you have made some sort of agreement to let the past be the past. The way your person views the situation right now, well, they're looking at it from a different perspective. We see the Hanged Man. They're trying to seek answers, you know, look at things from your perspective. We have the energy of how they see you. They see you as very stable, very loving. You are a person for whom they really should marry. They recognize that you are very powerful. This is your energy, Aries. So we have Aries energy. We have Scorpio energy. We have Cancerian energy. And we have Pisces energy. In their heart space, Six of Swords. They feel as though they have to move away from trouble. They feel like they're in turbulent waters in this relationship. So it does show that they're in that boat alone. So we'll have to see how that works itself out. How they view the situation going forward. Very intellectually, very aloof, really making head over heart decisions. These are both Aquarius cards. So, you know, Aquarius is your 11th house of friendship and hopes and dreams coming true. So I feel as though there's a pretty big divide here on the table. What's the energy that's hidden beneath the two of you or beneath the surface here? You both want to throw caution to the winds. You both want to have a new beginning. You want to be more upbeat, more exciting, more fun. And I feel like, you know, this is definitely heavy energy based on the fact that you haven't had as much fun probably in the past year as you did previous times. For those of you who are in long-term relationships, Spirit is really saying that what you should do in this relationship is think it through very carefully. It's better to be alone with than with someone who is not compatible. So Spirit is really saying, go within, search for answers, don't do anything right now. Just keep quiet, keep still, and things will work themselves out. Okay. So nice energy. What a nice way to come to the outcome of this reading at this time for the month of October is the Three of Cups. You really are moving forward into this energy, Two of Cups, Three of Cups, of really being best friends again, of being very close again, of celebrating life again. And so it's a powerful time in your relationship. So let's look and see what we have for the Judgment card. The energy here for the Judgment card, let's see what it is as a clarifier. Seven of Wands, both of you, the two of you have been competing, the two of you had been in the recent past in this sort of low-level fighting, you know, defending yourself, jabbing at the other person. So you have given that up, and that's a very powerful, smart thing to do, is that you both have released that energy. The Two of Cups currently, ooh, la la, we have lots of passion for you, Aries. This is beautiful energy that's all about a lot of communication, a lot of texting, a lot of talking, and hey, put the fire extinguisher next to the bed. I hear it squeaking. All right. Your person is really just holding off making a decision. The Five of Cups says that your person doesn't feel very satisfied in some way in the relationship. And it says that they're going to let go of, you know, being sad. They're holding on to the Two Cups of Love. So it is a very positive indicator that they really want this relationship with the Two of Cups. So I like it, you know, letting go of the past, you know, looking at things from a different perspective helps them release some of that negative energy. The way they view you is they see you being very quiet right now. And of course, you're in hermit mode. That's exactly what spirit wants you to do. If you don't know the answer to something, it's always good to go quiet, look within, and not say much. The Six of Swords is how they feel. The truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth is that there is a desire on their part to cut ties and have a new beginning, a new passionate beginning, and they don't even know where that's going to be. But an Ace of Swords, an Ace of Wands, let's see what else we can find out. Will that be with our Aries? Will that person want to initiate something new with Aries? Queen of Swords is Libra energy, so they are very much all about being very logical. Ah, the Queen of Wands, there you are. So I would say that your person, if you're very logical and you're very straightforward and you're very enthusiastic, you know, that they would definitely choose to be back in the relationship and give it more attention than they have. But when we have two queens, we can never, ever, ever eliminate the thought process that there might be someone that they're speaking to. Now, they could be using Queen of Swords energy. Queen of Swords, King of Swords means that you could be odd man out on somebody that they feel very connected to, because that's a divine couple. And the Queen of Wands is typically, you know, the very sexy, very brilliant Aries queen. So I don't think you're out of the woods. When we looked at your main life path reading, it was very significant what we saw there. And so I just think that you keeping on, go on, stay on your own path. Don't worry about what this person is doing, because at the end of the day, you can't really control it, but you can choose to be happy on your own. And we have the Page of Wands. Look at the Page of Wands. It's clarifying the Page of Wands. So the two of you really do throw caution to the winds. You're both very much on the same page. You both want the relationship to work. The Four of Coins says that you are both holding on to one another. And the Three of Cups says your outcome is the King of Wands. Oh, look at you, King and Queen of Wands. So what I'm seeing here is, since we have both of these sets of divine partners within the relationship, I can now really go back here and address the fact that your person needs for you to be very logical at times. And they love your passion. They love your fire. They will match that as long as they feel as though they can talk to you in a very straightforward way, and that you will not necessarily get offended or feel insulted. Now, I will say this, based on your life path reading, you know, just pay attention. Pay attention to the details, but that is a very lovely reading of catharsis, of healing, of coming through difficult times in a love relationship. That's really how you do it. So let's take a look and see what the Seven Energy Oracle says, as has for you for advice about this situation. Aries, you are so incredibly lovely and loving in relationship, and you give so much, and you never ever really take credit for it. It's, you hope that other people will recognize it. Ears wide open. Okay. Make sure that you hear absolutely everything that someone is saying to you, and let's see what this person's energy is. When we look at them in this sort of negative Six of Swords energy, what is that? What is it that they have clarity about? It does show that your person feels as though they would definitely leave. They know that, but let's see what they're bringing. Lady of Joy. So what I would say is this, is that this person has a low tolerance for anything that's not all upbeat. But you know, in a partnership, you really need somebody. You need somebody who can be there for the highs and the lows, right? Till death do us part kind of things, in sickness and in health, you know, and and abundance and, you know, the lack thereof. So I see this person loves it when you're all upbeat and you're happy, then that's wonderful. But the messenger is really telling us that that is a very, that's a pretty high order to place, you know, on the feet or at the feet of a relationship. So I'm going to leave your love relationship there, and we're going to go into the astrology. Thank you so much.